Can you imagine that this small tiny little particle, which size is less than 200 nanometer, has caused the whole world to suffer from the coronavirus pandemic disease? We are going to clarify the mystery of coronavirus. But first, let's go back to the 19th century when scientists began studying viruses, as they found that a factor smaller than bacteria could cause disease. Later in the 1930s, they invented the electron microscope, and the tobacco mosaic virus was the first virus to be seen. Have you ever wondered, where did viruses came from, or how did the first virus arise? There are two main hypotheses explaining this. The first is that small viruses started as one-way pieces of nucleic acid originally came from bacteria, and large viruses were once parasitic cells inside bigger host cells. Over time, genes needed to survive outside host cells were lost. The virus structure. A virus is a non-living organism made up of nucleic acid and covered by either a protein coat or a lipoprotein coat. The viruses are not living because they lack some key characteristics of living organisms. They don't have cytoplasm or organelles, they cannot carry out cellular functions, and they don't grow as cells by dividing. They must enter a living cell and uses the host cell's ribosomes, enzymes, ATP to reproduce. Viruses vary in size and shape. The shape of the virus depends on the protein coat surrounding it. Some viruses have only one layer, like the TMV virus has a helical shape and the adenovirus has an exohedron shape. Some viruses have a bilipid membrane, like the influenza virus has a spherical shape. How do viruses cause disease? First, it enters the body, then target tissues in which to replicate in. After replication, it gets out of the cell to infect other cells. Finally, it exits the body for transmission and cause disease to other hosts. Viruses could enter the body through food, skin, respiratory tract, and blood. And the hardest viruses to be prevented are those who enter the body through the respiratory tract. And this is the case of coronavirus. That's why it's widely spread all over the world. Now then, how the infection happens. The latest research suggests that the virus has a surface of proteins that binds to specific cell receptors found in the heart, lungs, kidneys, and intestine. First, it infects the cells lining the throat and lungs to start multiplying and spreading in the body. As it enters the lungs, it causes inflammation to the mucous membranes and damages the air sacs, reducing the lungs' ability to oxygenate the blood. In severe cases, it leads to pneumonia. At the time, there is no vaccination to end the virus, but scientists are still working and researching on it. You were listening to Duran Ghanim. Thanks for watching.